Very well. So in this episode, we are going to talk about two players that Arsenal are going to make a bid for very soon. How soon? Well, they've really bid for some people already, but they will be making some really concrete bids. We're going to debunk certain theories and, of course, some fake news as well. No, we're not talking about my thumbnails. We're only talking about the fake news that is going on around in the social media. Let's just jump into it. Why to waste your, my, and everyone's time? So Arsenal's 13.5 million bid for, we all know that this, according to Mail Sport, that Albert Sambilokonga cancelled, rejected. Straight away said, on, right, slapped on the face that no, that's not the price tag that you need, that we need. We are seeking a better prize money. So what is the price that would take Albert Sambilokonga away from Anderlecht and bring him to Arsenal for a backup for Thomas Teye Partey? Pretty much simple. Add more £5 million to it. Anderlecht are wanting £18 million. I think £18 or £17 million is a region where they could reach, you know, they could actually reach, you know, agreement too about it. So that's what we know. But we have to open about those important things as well. Now, what are those important things? Well, it is pretty much clear. Albert Sambilokonga, Arsenal have had a bid of £13.5 million rejected, according to Simon Jones, by Anderlecht. The Belgian side want closer to £18 million for him. But here's the good part. Albert Sambilokonga's agent is a lawyer who used to work at the same law firm as Arsenal executive director Tim Lewis. Lewis is not involved in direct negotiations when it comes to transfers, but his influence may prove beneficial, according to Chris Wheatley. The Athletic understands that Arsenal intend to make several significant additions to their first team squad during this window, with any resources allocated to squad building likely to be supplemented by revenue from player sales. Now, let's talk about the big one. Okay. So let's talk about Ben White. You know, Brighton are expected to demand between £40 and £50 million for 23-year-old Ben White, though that figure is unlikely to be insurmountable for Arsenal. But according to Athletic.uk, Arsenal's interest in Ben White has not yet developed into a formal offer to Brighton, although that is expected to follow. The club has been seeking a new right-sided centre-half, and following their pursuit of Jules Koundé, White is now the primary target, because the price tag of... Yeah. This is the English tax that we need to pay. And more importantly, Jules Koundé, the Spanish release clause tax that everyone has to pay if they want him, you know. Moving on, according to Athletic.uk, Arsenal still intend to sign a number 10 this summer and are set to explore other options more aggressively. Well, yes, that is true, actually. And talking about Martin Odegaard, you know, Athletic.co.uk say, Real Madrid were resistant to Odegaard leaving the club on loan in January until he pushed for the move. It would likely require a similar course of action for a deal to happen this summer, and there is no indication of that happening, at least for now. The main reason why? No Zidane, baby. That's the only profitable outcome. So, according to Chris Wheatley, Thomas Partey in an interview says he has launched his own foundation with the aim of creating opportunities for underprivileged youngsters in Ghana. Now, he says that he would want to bring in the talent from the deepest part of Ghana to the major part of Europe. Of course, he would want to do that. So that is superb. Superb. Also, congratulations to Bukayo Saka, William Saliba, Gabriel Martinelli and Folwyn Balogun on being nominated for the 2021 Golden Boy Award. Crazy stuff. Super crazy stuff, if you ask me. But let's see how things develop next. Now, what do we have for you about Matteo Guendouzi? Well, it's understood that Matteo is... Yeah. Chris Wheatley says Marseille and Benfica have both been linked with Matteo Guendouzi in recent days. He is still expected to leave Arsenal this summer, but a member of his entourage told me yesterday that his future remains uncertain. So for now, he's an Arsenal player. That's the whole Twitter bio change. But let's see. So this is the new ball, ladies and gentlemen, for the 2020-2021 Premier League. Yes, that's the new ball for the new Premier League season. It looks sick. It's really good. I like it. That's all I've got to say about it. Moving on. So Steve Clarke has opened up whether Kieran Tierney will get a chance against England. Will he be fit? Well, you all know that It was not available because of a little bit of niggle. But you know what happened with Scotland, right? That was a really, really bad thing. So here's what Clark had to say. He says he did a little bit of light training and we will just see how he progresses. He's got a chance. Well, Tierney's absence, we all know what happened. There was like a death warrant issued and the team really collapsed badly. Moving on, so according to a source called One, and that's what they call, I'm sorry. Arsenal are set to make an offer for Shakhtar Donetsk Israel star Manor Solomon. Shakhtar want 25 million euros for the winger, but as soon as the official offer from the Gunners arrives, the parties will enter into negotiations to reach a compromise. They're all waiting for one. Let's see what happens. Andre Onana, according to Charles Watts, Arsenal face, there's a big problem with Onana coming to Arsenal. Now what is that? Well, Arsenal face competition to sign Onana. Now, the interest is really grown since his verdict, but Arsenal have not made an offer yet. Now what's the problem? That's not just the only problem, that there are many others who are bidding for Onana. If Onana comes in, of course, after some period of time, he would want to be the number one. He would want to join only if he starts as a number one at a club. Now at Arsenal, is that possible? If Leno stays, it's difficult until January, but still there is still a possibility. But let's see. Arsenal have definitely stepped up their interest, but the situation is very much complicated because of Leno. Let's see if Arsenal are selling Leno, what will be the price tag? I really don't know. So I would want to ask you guys, would you want, of course, you know, Andre Onana is not going to get you straight away. He's not going to get straight away game time. He's going to have to spend some time out because of the ban. So until then, would you want Leno or what? How is it going to be? Like, you want him, of course, he doesn't want to be going to a club where he's number two. So it's still a big concern. Moving on. So Granit Xhaka on Instagram shared this image with the caption, "Big task for us against Italy, but we are ready to fight for everything." Gabriel Magalhães asked him, "What hair, my friend?" If I was Gabriel, I would have written something really bad, but okay. Like, I would have made him fell, like, shut up. Anyways. So Chris Wheatley has debunked the whole reports about Manor Solomon to Arsenal. He says, more reports coming out today that Arsenal are preparing an offer for Manor Solomon. I'm told that there has been no contact from Arsenal and no club has yet to make an offer for the Shakhtar Donetsk midfielder. That's the update. That's what you need to know right now. Well, another source, it's James Olley. Now, he's also confirmed the whole Albert Sambi Lokonga thing. So he says that Arsenal have had a £12.9 million bid rejected by Anderlecht for Albert Sambi Lokonga. Arsenal have been told a few the same old thing. James Olley also says Mikel Arteta is keen on strengthening his midfield options this summer with Ceballos now back at Madrid. Granit Xhaka in negotiations to join Roma and several others including Matteo Guendouzi and Lucas Torreira available for transfer. So it's going to be a very big window. But here's the problem. I hate the Euros, man. It's just blocking a lot of development. Like, for now. Moving on. So talking about Wilfred Zaha, according to Caught Offside, who I hardly believe in. Well, Crystal Palace chief have offered Arsenal and Tottenham hopes of clinching Wilfred Zaha transfer. Now, we all know there was all the lots of problems, but still, Steve Parrish opened up about Zaha recently. He says, there are lots of talks about transfers and that kind of thing. All I know is that when he crosses the white line, he gives 100% and everything else, what will be, will be. We know his position and there is a lot of love around the club for Wilfred and everything he has done for us as a football club. Of course, it's no secret that he likes to challenge himself, but it has to be right for the football club as well. And he understands that. If those two things collide, we will have to look at it. But right now, it's a bit early to talk about. Bullshit. I don't get it. Okay, whatever it is, it is. Okay, you don't 100% believe in it. It is what it is. So with this, I'd like to end this episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this video, hit that like button. Doesn't charge you anything. That's the best way to support me. You know, like button. If you do not like it, dislike it. comment and let me know who should be Arsenal's number one starting new season. Should it be Bernd Leno? Of course it'll be Bernd Leno. You know Onana can't start. But still, if Onana cannot start, can he continue? Because if he continues, Leno sits out on the bench. And if that happens, he would want to leave next summer. Let's see. Let me know what you want. What do you want? Yeah? I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.